Mulberry Springs. We're not going there. Take a little right. Mrs. Orcutt realized that the new interstate, Interstate 40, was going to completely bypass her. So she started writing letters. And she didn't get any response, so she wrote more letters and more letters. And she wrote to the president and finally got through. So the United States government decided that in order to keep Mrs. Orcutt connected, they're going to build her a driveway. Well, it's a 4-mile long driveway. That's right. This is Mrs. Orcutt's driveway. They built it, and then sometime in the 70s, some of the guys from Car and Driver magazine found out about it and realized that since only one person lives on here, we go, it hasn't been maintained in a long time. Okay. Oh my. So the guys from Car and Driver found out about it and started doing high speed testing. And there's articles, I gotta find them. There are some articles about, 200 miles per hour out here. It's 4 miles of a straight. Yeah, we're still on it. Can you imagine this thing? Nice and smooth. A black ribbon.
the train over there.
Mrs. Orcutt's house. Wow, what a driveway, huh?
Is it made of adobe?
Oh, does she have a pool? Or a lake?
Well, maybe she did. That'd be smart.
All the lava. Made of adobe, it looks like. Well, there you got it. This is Orcutt's, not only Mrs. Orcutt's driveway, but Mrs. Orcutt's house. Amazing. Out here, the things you find off the beaten path.
All right, that's it for Mrs. Orcutt's house. We still got 4 more miles of Mrs. Orcutt's driveway, though. But I won't bore you with that. You saw enough coming in to know what it's all about. Mrs. Orcutt's driveway in the 55. Do you see it? Can you see it? Pavement. Sweet. Sweet. Smooth pavement. All right, yeah. Thanks, you guys, for coming along. Miss Orcutt's driveway. That was an adventure. And we're off in the 55. Thanks for watching.